हाय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू टाइम टू लर्न टीएनपीएनसी। இன்னைக்கு நம்ம பார்க்க போற சாப்டர் னா ஹியூமன் ஆர்கன் சிஸ்டம்ஸ். இன்ட்ரோடக்ஷன். ஆர்கன் சிஸ்டம்ஸ் ஆர் ஃபார்ம்டு பை தி அசோசியேஷன் ஆஃப் ஆர்கன்ஸ் விச் ஆர் ஆர்கனைஸ்டு ஃப்ரம் டிஷ்யூஸ். திஸ் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ஆர்கனைசேஷன் ஹெல்ப்ஸ் த ஆர்கானிசம்ஸ் டு பெர்ஃபார்ம் வேரியஸ் ஆக்டிவிட்டீஸ் மோர் எஃபிஷியன்ட்லி. எ குரூப் ஆஃப் ஆர்கன்ஸ் தட் ஒர்க் டுகெதர் டு பெர்ஃபார்ம் எ பர்டிகுலர் ஃபங்க்ஷன் இஸ் நோன் அஸ் அன் ஆர்கன் சிஸ்டம். த ஹியூமன் பாடி ஹஸ் 8 மேஜர் ஆர்கன் சிஸ்டம்ஸ். தே ஆர் ஸ்கெலிட்டல் சிஸ்டம், மஸ்குலர் சிஸ்டம், டைஜஸ்டிவ் சிஸ்டம், ரெஸ்பிரேட்டரி சிஸ்டம், சர்க்குலேட்டரி சிஸ்டம், நர்வஸ் சிஸ்டம், எண்டோக்ரைன் சிஸ்டம், எக்ஸ்கிரேட்டரி சிஸ்டம். ஸ்கெலிட்டல் சிஸ்டம். த ஸ்கெலிட்டல் சிஸ்டம் கன்சிஸ்ட் ஆஃப் போன்ஸ், cartilages and joints. Bones provide a framework for the body. Bones along with muscles help in movements such as walking, running, chewing and dancing. The adult human skeletal system consists of 206 bones and few cartilages, ligaments and tendons. Ligaments help in connecting bone to bone. Tendons connect bone to muscle. The two major divisions of the skeletal system are axial skeleton and appendicular skeleton. Axial skeleton form the upright axis of the body, which includes skull, vertebral column, rib cage. Appendicular skeleton consists of the bones of the limbs along with their skeletal system, skull, spinal column, ribs, ulna, pelvis, femur, tibia. Skull. The skull is made up of cranial bones and facial bones. It protects the brain and structure of the face. The hyoid bone present at the base of the buccal activity and the auditory osseous, malleus, incus and stapes also included in the skull. Lower jaw bone is the largest and strongest bone in the human face. Skull. Parietal bone, temporal bone, occipital bone, lower jaw, frontal bone and nasal bone. Vertebral column. Vertebral column extends from the base of the skull. It protects the spinal cord. It is formed by a number of serially arranged small bones called vertebra, singular vertebra. Rib cage. The rib cage is made up of 12 pairs of curved flat rib bones. It protects the delicate vital organs such as heart and lungs. Limbs. Men has two pairs of limbs, namely upper limbs, forelimbs and lower limbs, hind limbs. Forelimbs are used for holding, writing, etc., while hind limbs are used for walking, sitting, etc. Girdles. The forelimbs and hind limbs are attached to the axial skeleton with the help of the pectoral and pelvic girdle respectively. Do you know the smallest bone in our body is present inside the ear? It is called stapes. It is only 2.8 millimeters long, average length. The longest bone in the body is the thigh bone, femur. A newborn baby has more than 300 bones. As a baby grows, some bones are joined together. Hence the skeleton of an adult has 206 bones. Muscular system. In the body, muscular system along with the skeletal and nervous system is responsible for the body movements. Muscles can contract and therefore help in moving other parts of the body. It maintains the posture and body position. There are three types of muscles, namely skeletal muscle, smooth muscle and cardiac muscle. How do muscles work? Muscles of the body can only pull and they cannot push. Two muscles are required to move a bone at a joint. When one muscle contracts, the other muscles relaxes. For example, to move the lower arm up and down, two type of muscles called biceps and triceps are required. When we raise our lower hand, the biceps in front become short by contraction and the triceps at the back stretch to pull up the arm. When we lower our arm, the triceps at the back contract and biceps stretch to pull the arm down. How do muscles work? Muscles of the body can only pull and they cannot push. Two muscles are required to move a bone at a joint. When one muscle contracts, the other muscles relaxes. For example, to move the lower arm up and down, two types of muscles called biceps and triceps are required. When we raise our lower hand, the biceps in front become short by the contraction and the triceps at the back stretch to pull up the arm. When we lower our arm, the triceps at the back contract and the biceps stretch to pull the arm down. Skeletal muscles. Skeletal muscles of our body are attached to the bones. They are voluntary muscles because they can be controlled by our will. Example muscles of arm. Tendon, bone, blood vessels, muscle fiber. Smooth muscles. Smooth muscles are found in the walls of the digestive tract, urinary bladder, arteries, and other internal organs. They are called the involuntary muscles because they are not controlled by our will. Stomach, pancreas, and intestines. Cardiac muscles. The walls of the heart is made up of cardiac muscles. They are capable of rhythmic contraction continuously and involuntary in nature. Muscular system. Fingal flexors. Bend the fingers. Fingal extensors. Behind straighten the fingers. Biceps. Bonds the arm at the elbow. Triceps. Straightens the elbow. Digestive systems. Digestive system consists of the alimentary canal and associate glands. The system is involved in the conversion of complex food substance into simple forms and absorption of digested food. The digestive glands associated with the alimentary canal are salivary glands, liver and pancreas. They secrete enzymes which helps in the process of digestion of food in the digestive tract or alimentary canal. The alimentary canal is about 9 meters long. Stomach is a major organ for digestion of food materials. Absorption of digested food occurs in the small intestine. Parts of alimentary canal. Mouth, buccal activity, pharynx, oesophagus or food pipe, stomach, small intestine, large intestine and anus. Associate glands for digestion. Salivary glands, gastric glands, liver, pancreas, intestinal glands. Digestive system. Mouth starts mechanical and chemical digestion of food with the help of teeth, tongue and saliva, liver. Blood carrying nutrients from the small intestine passes through the liver, which filter it and breaks down and synthesizes proteins, converts glucose into glycogen and also produce bile. Small intestine, a long tube about 6 meters in which most of the chemical digestion occurs. Nutrients are absorbed from here into the bloodstream. Salivary glands produces saliva which helps to lubricate food for easier swallowing. Contains antibacterial agents and the enzyme salivary amylase which breaks down starch. Stomach stores, mixes and digests food with the gastric juice it produces, which consists of mucus, enzymes and hydrochloric acid. Large intestine absorbs water from the food that have not been digested in the small intestine. Also absorbs some important vitamins that are produced by the large number of bacteria it harbors. Respiratory system. Respiratory system is involved in exchange of respiratory gases and thereby help us to breathe. The human respiratory system consists of nostrils, nasal cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi and lungs. It helps in the movement of air in and out of the body. Exchange of O2, oxygen and carbon dioxide occurs between air in the lung and blood. The entry of food into the windpipe is prevented by a flag-like structure called epiglottis. Lungs. Lungs are the main respiratory organ. They are located within the chest cavity. The trachea, commonly called windpipe, is a tube supported by cartilaginous rings that connects the pharynx and larynx to the lungs, allowing the passage of air. The trachea divides into right and left bronchi and enter into the lungs. They divide further and ends in small air sacs called alveoli. The lungs are covered by a double layer pleura. Diffusion of gases O2 and CO2 occurs across the alveoli. alveolar membrane. Respiratory system. Nasal cavity. The temperature and humidity of the air we breathe is adjusted in the cavities. Bronchus. Lung, where gas exchange occurs. Diaphragm. When we inhale, where does the air go? Nostrils to nasal cavity, nasal cavity to pharynx, pharynx to larynx, larynx to trachea, trachea to bronchus, bronchus to bronchiole, bronchiole to alveolus. Exchange of gases by the respiratory system involves three different processes such as external respiration. Intake of O2 from the air and releasing of CO2 from the lungs occurs through nostrils. Internal respiration, taking in of oxygen and giving out CO2. The circulatory system transports O2 and CO2 to and from all parts of the body. Hemoglobin in the red blood cells, RBC, transports O2 and CO2. Cellular respiration, cells take in O2 and release CO2. Do you know? Each lung has about 3 million air sacs of alveoli. Yawning helps us to take in more amount of O2 and give out CO2. Circulatory system. The circulatory system is one of the important systems, consists of heart, blood vessels and blood. It transports respiratory gases, nutrients, hormones and waste materials within the body. It protects the body from harmful pathogens and also regulates the body temperature. Circulatory system. Superior vena cava. Aorta. Heart pumps blood to the body. Capillaries are very narrow tubes not shown in this diagram. They connect the ends of the all arteries to veins. They deliver and pick up gases, nutrients and waste products. Pulmonary artery carries blood from the right ventricle to the lungs. Pulmonary veins carries blood from the lungs to the left atrium. Arteries shown in red color shown pannirukanga, they carry blood from the heart to all parts of the body except the pulmonary arteries carry oxygenated red blood. Veins shown in blue, they carry blood from all parts of the body back to the heart. All veins except the pulmonary veins carry blood that is depleted of oxygen and therefore bluish in color. Heart is located in the thoracic cavity between the two lungs. The heart is four chambered and is surrounded by a double layered membrane called pericardium. The heart pumps blood continuously throughout our lifetime. Sinus node, right atrium, AV node, right ventricle, left atrium and left ventricle. Blood vessels. Three types of blood vessels are present in the body. They are arteries, veins and capillaries. They form a closed network through which the blood is circulated. Blood is a fluid connective tissue of red color containing plasma and blood cells. There are three types of blood cells, namely red blood corpuscles, white blood corpuscles and blood platelets. RBCs are produced in the bone marrow. Nervous system. Nervous system is well developed in humans and is composed of neurons or nerve cells. The system includes brain, spinal cord, sensory organs and nerves. The two important functions of the nervous system along with the endocrine systems are conduction and coordination. Nervous system brain. Brain is the part of the central nervous system that regulates and controls activity throughout the body, the site of consciousness and memory. Spinal cord. It is a bundle of nerves extending from the brain stem through the backbone, conducts signals to and from the brain. Intercostal nerves, radial nerves, femoral nerves, peripheral nerves are the network of nerves and ganglion that carry signals to and from the central nervous system. The brain. The brain is a complex organ which is placed inside the cranium. It is protected by a three-layer tissue covering called meninges. Brain has three regions, namely forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. It is the controlling center of the body, cerebrum, cerebellum and medulla oblongata. Spinal cord. It is the extension of medulla oblongata of the hindbrain and is enclosed within the vertebral column. Spinal cord connects the brain to different parts of the body through nerves. The functions of the nervous system. Sensory input. The conduction of signals from sensory receptors. Integration. The interpretation of the sensory signals and the formulation of responses. Motor output. The conduction of signals from the brain and spinal cord to effectors such as muscle and gland cells. Do you know? Brain is said to store as many as 100 million bits of information in a lifetime. Sense organs. Sense organs are like the windows to the outside world. There are 5 sense organs in our body such as eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. They make us aware of our surroundings. We are able to see, hear, smell, taste and feel only through sense organs. Eyes. Eyes help us to see things around us. Their color, shape, size, whether they are near or far, moving or at rest. The eyelids and the eyelashes keep the eyes safe. The eye has 3 main parts, namely cornea, iris and pupil. Iris, lens, pupil, cornea and retina. Ears. Ears helps to hear and differentiate sound around us. The ears also help us in maintaining the balance of the body when we are walking, running or climbing. The ear has 3 major parts, the outer ear, the middle ear and the inner ear. The outer ear in human beings is made up of an external flap called pinna. Outer ear, pinna, eardrum, middle ear and inner ear. Skin. Skin is the largest sense organ as it covers the whole body. The skin helps to feel the things around us by touching, that is whether they are hot or cold, smooth or rough, dry or wet, hard or soft. Skin covers the body and protects it from the germs. It also keeps the body moist and regulates the body temperature. Epidermis, dermis and hypodermis. Functions of the skin. Skin forms an effective barrier against infection by microbes and pathogens. Skin helps us to synthesize vitamin D using sunlight. Endocrine system. Endocrine system regulates various functions of the body and maintains the internal environment. Endocrine glands are present in the body, produce a chemical substance called hormones. Endocrine systems. Pineal gland, thymus, ovary in female, testicle in male, hypothalamus, pituitary gland, thyroid and parathyroid glands, pancreas, adrenal glands. Glands and their location. Pituitary gland at the base of brain, pineal gland at the base of brain, thyroid gland neck, thymus gland chest, pancreas, islets of the Langerhans, abdomen, adrenal gland above the kidney, gonads, pelvic cavity. Excretory system. The nitrogenous waste are removed from the body by the excretory system. It is composed of kidneys, ureters, urinary bladder and urethra. Excretory system. Renal artery brings blood containing oxygen and urea from the aorta to the kidneys. Renal vein brings filtered blood from the kidneys to the interior vena cava. Ureter carries urine from the kidney to the urinary bladder. Kidneys just inside the back ribs regulate the chemical composition of fluids in the body. Urinary bladder, an expandable muscular sac that retains urine until it is discharged from the body. Urethra, the tube through which urine is discharged from the body. It is surrounded by muscles that allow us to control urination. Kidneys. These are bean-shaped structures present in the abdominal cavity. The functional units of the kidney are called nephrons, which filter the blood and form the urine. Blood with waste, blood without waste, ureter, kidney, medulla, cortex, blood and urine. Do you know why do we drink water? Our body contains about 70% water. Some parts have more water, like the gray matter of the brain, about 85%, and some, like less fat cell, about 15%. We normally consume 1.5 to 3.5 liters of water every day in the form of food and water. Points to remember: the skeletal system gives shape to the body and protects the soft internal organs. There are three types of muscles: skeletal muscle, voluntary; smooth muscle, involuntary; and cardiac muscle. Circulatory system constitutes the heart, blood vessels, and the blood. Diaphragm, a large flat muscle forming the floor at the chest cavity. Digestion is the process of breaking complex food into simple and soluble substances. Brain is protected by the skull. It has three parts: cerebrum, cerebellum, and medulla oblongata. The sense organs are eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin. Thank you. Please share, subscribe, and comment.